How's it going, everyone? Jerry's here with some more Empires, and we're gonna try something a little different today, see how it goes, and yeah, so today I want to talk about gaming and why we choose the games that we choose, and what do we find appealing, really. So when it comes to gaming for me, let me look for a battle while we're chatting here. When it comes to gaming for me, looking for a good game, I put fun above everything. The game has to be fun. The gameplay has to be fun, because that's what you're going to be doing for hours on end when you play the game. Correct? So for me, fun has to be a number one factor for any game. Storyline, if there's a great storyline, that makes the game even better. But even if the storyline's not that good, and the gameplay is still fun, it could still be a really fun game. You catch my drift? So, let's just do a little quest or something. Let me use an example. A game that is a load of fun, and it has a great story. To me, Assassin's Creed Rogue. I thought that game was amazing. Had an awesome story, to the point, the graphics were decent. But the graphics are not a huge thing for me. The gameplay was a lot of fun, and I really enjoyed the story. So that is a great game to me. Another game that the combat is a lot of fun, but I didn't really like the story all that much. Dragon Ball Xenoverse. I thought the combat in that game was absolutely amazing. I actually platinumed that game recently. And that game is a load of fun, and I really, really enjoyed playing that game. Or killing some tigers. But the story, I didn't really find the story all that interesting. It was just whatever to me, but I had fun playing the game, and that's why I kept playing it. That's why fun is the number one thing for me. Now we're really beating these guys down. This is my new horse. His name's Sancho. So there's other things that make a game appealing, like graphics. Let's use an example, Assassin's Creed Unity. Fantastic graphics. Those graphics were nuts. I was like, man, these are so good. But the gameplay was really lacking. The game mechanics, some of the mechanics in the game did not work properly. So it really killed the fun for me in the game overall. So that's just an example of how graphics do not make a game. Some of you may agree with me, some of you may disagree with me. That's fine, you may have your opinion. Be sure to share it in the comments. But for me, gameplay and story, gameplay is number one, story is number two, and everything else after that is just a plus. Awesome graphics, that's a plus. If it has bad graphics, but it's a lot of fun, I will live with that. If it has great graphics and it's a lot of fun, then that is just awesome. Those are the games that usually get like Game of the Year and stuff, like Shadow of Mordor. That game was like, wow, like they went above and beyond in that game. They really did. Let's blow this girl up. I don't even know if this will kill her. But everybody has their own different idea of what's fun, you know? So, fun for me, I really like open world games. If you guys could see on my channel, sometimes you'll see some open world stuff here. Or you'll hear me talk about it in the commentary if you watch some of my videos. Some of you may be new here. And I really like open world stuff, like Assassin's Creed. There was another game I used to play, Kingdom of Amalur, I believe it was. Pretty cool game. I love the combat system in that game, but it wasn't exactly open world. I didn't feel like it was really open world like they said it was. So I was like, what the hell? Let's kill these guys. But it was a fun game. The combat was pretty cool. We got a tiger here to kill. And that's what attracted me, was the gameplay. So I ended up playing that game. It wasn't too difficult of a game. You get to about level 20 or so, and the game becomes pretty easy after that. I think the max level was 30 or something like that. But gameplay, man, gameplay. It's all about the gameplay. There's a few games that I like really enjoy the gameplay of, like Dynasty Warriors. I've been seeing the story of this game since Dynasty Warriors 2. So now I start to buy this game pretty much for the gameplay now. I like this kind of game. I like going around slashing people up. It's all about fun. This is all fun to me. I like chopping a hell out of people. I like beating them down using a Musou attack. And I like seeing the graphical enhancements, which is nice as well. But it's not mandatory for me. But it's all pretty cool. Oh, John Holger, a B rank. Awesome. But there's so many aspects to liking a game. Like for me, I like the fun, I like the gameplay, but some people prefer the story above all else, above everything. Some people prefer a character. Let's say there's a game that's complete dog shit. The game, like the gameplay, everything is terrible, but it has your favorite character in the world in there. Would you still buy the game? You probably would. There's a chance that you might get the game. You'll be like, this game is so bad, but this character is so awesome, and I can't turn down this game. You ever been in a situation like that? I've always, like, I'm like, I want to get this game, but it's, I just want it for this character, but it's so bad. Like, I'm debating, do I wait for a price drop? Do I get it now and bitch about it later? It's weird how we go around picking out games and stuff. And then you got the trailers that come out. They put these YouTube trailers out. And they false advertise a lot of these games. Like, they make it seem amazing, like a completely different game. And then when you get it, then it's like, this doesn't look anything like the trailer. Like, the trailer had all this cool, magical stuff. And it was crazy. The graphics even looked better. And now I'm playing the real game, and it's like, what's going on? I don't understand. You know, it's that's been happening a lot lately, actually. I don't know what's going on with the companies, but that has definitely been going on, man. Let's go for that. It's an iron cane. I think that looks like a weapon for us. I don't know. It could be. And then there's other things, like, when it comes to picking out a game, developers. Maybe there's a developer that you've trusted. Like, let's say you grew up on Pokemon. I grew up on Pokemon. I started off on Blue, Red, Yellow, all the old school stuff. Let's say you've trusted them since forever. You're just going to buy all their games no matter what. Or you're a Koei Tecmo fan. You're going to buy all the Koei Tecmo games no matter what. Some people buy depending who the developer is. Me, I would love to buy all the Koei Tecmo games, but there's a few here that I really do not enjoy. Example, Bladestorm. I could never get into Bladestorm. I don't know why. I've tried. I even tried the demo for the Nightmare version. I could not get into the game. It was just it feels very awkward playing the game, you know? And I could just never get into it. Oh, these packs of wolves. They're taking some hits, these little guys, man. But, and then there's other things, like, I know some people that literally when they get a game, they look at little things in a game like graphical stuff, like water, for example. I know a lot of people like to look at water in the games, and they like to compare the water to another game. They're like, oh, look at this water, it's so nice. You could probably look up videos on YouTube about just, I think I saw one a few years ago, but a dude just looking up water, and I thought it was funny. They have summoned for help, what the hell? How did the wolf unit summon for help? I don't even understand. But, like, stuff like that, like, there's a lot of different aspects to attract people to games. Maybe you like swords and spears. I really, really love swords and spears. And by the way, the Heroic Legend of Arslan, guys, that is coming to PS3 and PS4. If you've ever seen that anime, which is going to be totally fucking awesome. It's going to be a Musou game, so chances are I'm going to get that. Hopefully we get an English release. If not, maybe I will get the Japanese version. I don't know. For the most part, I generally get the English release so I can support releases to the West, you know? Which I think is the best thing to do so we can get more games. Let's blow up Blue Bay if we can. Oh, we didn't blow him up at all. But that game, I'm totally gonna be looking forward to that game, so that's gonna be sweet. But me personally, I really like the whole idea of swords and spears. That's another reason why I love Skyrim so much. Because it's open world, one. Two is swords, spears, there's magic. Well, there's not spears. But I'm gonna die. But there's all kinds of cool stuff in there that I think is just awesome, you know? Where'd Lou Baby go? But this is why Dynasty Warriors works out for me even more. Like, I love swords and spears. I love this kind of combat. I love this stuff. It's, the day that Dynasty Warriors turns into, like, Call of Duty or something, I'm just never gonna play these games again. It's gonna be weird. But, anyway, that's just another thing. So, that's another thing that helps, that helps people choose games. Maybe there's something in the game. Oh, he's gonna die? Oh, whatever. He better not die. He's got 5 minutes to, well, he's got 5 minutes to die, I guess. But anyway, that's another thing that helps people choose games. What's in the game? You know, weapons. What kind of weapons are there? Maybe people prefer guns. Maybe people prefer, like, sci-fi stuff. Like, you're shooting lasers and pew-pew and flying around in spaceships. People like that stuff. I've never really been attracted into that stuff much, really. I've always been, like, a pretty big fan of, like, fist fighters. Like, Xenoverse is a lot of fun. Did I lose? Oh, no, we won. Like, Xenoverse is a lot of fun. I like the fighting games like that. I like Tekken. I've always liked Tekken. I don't like all fighting games, though. Just Tekken. Something about Tekken, it just attracts me to it. Let me see what else. Like Dynasty Warrior games. I've always liked these type of games. I like beating down tons of people. We got a lot of good stuff here, which I like. I like collecting a lot of things. We're not invading, but they're invading each other. Oh, well, we did that. And then you have other things like the sci-fi stuff I was talking about, like Star Wars. Battlefront is a fun game. That is actually a fun game. I played it on PSP, pretty awesome. I like the gameplay. I thought it was sweet. I was like, yeah, this is totally cool. I think it was first period. Was it third person or first? Whatever it was a lot of fun, okay? And the computer would beat your ass if you didn't know how to play either. It was like, oh shit, I'm in trouble. You get blown up and stuff. It was crazy. I guess we'll participate. And also, I'm going to change the length of these videos and stuff. I'm not going to make them so long anymore. I think 30 minutes is a little too long, personally. So for now, let's just train and just level up and get some more EXP so we can prepare ourselves. So guys, what overall, after all this babbling, what is this? Oh my god, there's no way I'm gonna marry you, old man. Anyway, after all this babbling and stuff, what exactly attracts you to games? Do you prefer a great story? Do you prefer graphics? Do you prefer gameplay above all else? Do you buy games because there's a specific character in the game? Do you buy it because a developer made it? What attracts you to a game? Do you always rely on a trailer on YouTube when you go for a game? I'm done looking at trailers for games. I'm done relying on trailers. I need to play a demo. I need to see actual gameplay. I can't. The trailers, they have been failing me for too long now. So, I'm done with trailers. But do you guys rely on trailers, or do you wait for your favorite YouTuber to upload a video and then you hear their opinion, or do you wait for like for a review to come up and you check out their opinion for a game? Do any of you guys pre-order at all? Anyway, actually, I like to pre-order, but I'm starting to stop pre-ordering. I'm probably not gonna pre-order from GameStop anymore because you get better deals pre-ordering on PSN. You save money doing it through PSN. And I got a 2 terabyte hard drive, so this is okay. Anyway, we're gonna do one more battle, but I'm gonna leave this little conversation off as, what attracts you to getting a game? What do you like in a game? What do you look for exactly? and be sure to let me know in the comment section. Also, do you like this kind of thing where we talk about a certain topic? If you do, let me know if you like this. And also, give me an idea in the comment section for a future topic. This is not scripted. This is just me live commentary, like I always am. Maybe in the future I will do some scripted stuff, because sometimes I will repeat myself, which could probably not be all that cool, but it is what it is, man. That's just sort of how I've been doing things anyway. But let me know your opinions in the comment section if you'd like to see more of these topic type of things. And like I said, give me some ideas if you'd like to see more. And anyway, let's get to some gameplay here. Let's do this, let's do some training. More training, get some more merits, level ourselves up. And we can... Oh, they're gonna form an alliance. What the hell? It is training. The one that increased merits is the one that levels me up, isn't it? Or is there something else that levels me up? I'm pretty sure it was... Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's training. Increase, my merits. I'm pretty sure merits is what levels me up, isn't it? At least I thought that's what it was. Yeah, it's merits, right? I need level ups. I'm really low level compared to everyone else. The food is simply delicious. I didn't cook that for you. I can assure you this. So probably after this invasion, we're probably gonna call this video, I guess, a day and be done with it. I think I'm gonna start doing 20 to 25 minute videos on units advance. Let's do this. Oh, what the fuck? Just us? Well, at least I'm almost, well, I'm higher level than Shenrong. That doesn't really do anything for me. I'm in trouble. Oh, I have a new weapon! Right? Yeah! Hell yeah! Oh, sweet! Change out my man weapon. This one? For that. Nice, we lose some damage, but we gain some perks. You know, it's not too bad. Yeah, I'm using Sancho. Yeah! Alright. Stratagem. I definitely want my recovery turret. And let's take... I don't know what to take with me. We'll take false orders, I guess. No. No. Yeah, we'll take it. Whatever. Let's get started. We're losing? Why? What happened? Oh, I forgot to change the battle things. Ah. Damn it. I knew I was missing something. Whoa, this guy's health bar. All of your friends get exploded now. Sun Xingzhong. This isn't looking good for us. Have some thunder. See if we can get a storm rush off Sun Xingzhong. Oh, we killed Musu! That was scary. Oh shit! There you go. Alright, sweet. I think we're doing good. god, we're taking forever to get this base. What is that base they want me to capture? Why is that glowing? Some Qin Zhong's back. Lumong. Damn it. Oh, they killed Lumong! Love this song. Surprise, motherfuckers. Yeah, this health, I actually took some damage there. Sun Sheng Zhong. Well, well, well. Friend, hello. Take the electricity. Oh, we got him. Oh, that's right. Someone was telling me about that. That's right. Someone told me use a Musou on the real officers, you'll get their weapon. That's right. That is totally right. Whoever was telling me about that, thanks. I just remembered now about that. Just a raid, really? Wow, what a beast. But I feel like my new horse is helping me. Now I'm getting all these Musou meters just for riding around. And that helps a lot. Where's Lucy? Surprise! Can I get some health, please? Yeah, fuck me. Shenrong, you're doing great. They're back? Jeez, that was quick. Let's get them, girl. Should I heal now, or... I'll heal now, that's fine. I probably didn't need to, but... better to be safe than sorry, right? Sun Si, Zhou Yu? Oh my god, look at all these people! Alright. Gotta watch out. Let the poison mist do some damage. Oh, we're stuck on that. I don't have enough meter for it, do I? Yes, I do. Not good enough. Just keep healing. They're always just chasing me. Oh, I'm stuck on something again. That's scary, man. See if I can get 50 health over here real fast. Oh, they stopped chasing me. Oh! He's right here! Show you, man. That's scary. Aw, Sun Si's there with you, though. Hugging your damn hand. That's just mean. Oh, you caught this! Perfect, I need the health. Hope there's some in here. Be a meat bun for me. No meat bun. They're just chasing me everywhere. This isn't even fair, man. Oh, did we do this? Looks like we did. How many people are attacking me here exactly? Like, what the hell did I do? Oh, nice. Oh, I thought I had a Musou. What the hell? I don't. No stun, no Musou meter? Aw, man. There it is. Oh, no, wait. I still don't have it, don't I? I figured I didn't have it yet. You know what? We've never seen the Raging Musou. Perfect. This is... Oh, man. This is so cool. I should get a few weapons for this. Oh, man. The Raging Musou is awesome. Wow. That is, like, the coolest thing here. One weapon. What are the rest of the weapons? No more? No way, I killed all those guys with the... Maybe I picked it up. Oh, whatever. My guess is I did pick it up by accident. No problem. Damn, so that means I want to get concentration for sure. Band of the Hawk attack. There's another person here I can... Oh! Hiya! Take a needle to the forehead. I wonder how long these last, the needles. That just disappeared. But it could be because the stage ended. I wonder how long they last. I'll have to test that another time. Oh, we failed. I didn't even check those. That was just a fail on my part anyway. Ooh, we got a new... Got another one. I can replace my other one now. Perfect. So I think we did okay. We got 3,200 merits. Sunzang Zhang. Ooh. Recruit. Yes. We're recruiting a lot of people. Perfect. So we still haven't decided who we're going to marry yet. I asked a few names last episode. No one said anything yet, so I'm just going to wait it out. Anyway, let's see what we have. We got some free stuff there. So guys, that's going to be it for this episode. Thanks for checking it out. I'll be looking forward to your comments in the comments section sometime soon. So till then, see ya.